Whenever the Prophet ﷺ asked for help when it came to Islam, the first person to respond was none other than Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala an. When the masjid needed an extension at the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, the Prophet ﷺ announced, whoever purchases this piece of land from his halal wealth, he will receive paradise. None other than Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala an, who responded to the call of the Prophet ﷺ. When the Muslims migrated from Mecca to Medina to Al-Munawwara and there was difficulty in regards to sweet water, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam announced, "Man yashtari ruma falahu al-jannah." Whoever purchases the well ruma, he will receive jannah. Again, it was Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu that responded to the call of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At the time of Tabuk, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the call, "Man jahaza jaysh al-usra falahu al-jannah." Whoever prepares the army of difficulty, he will receive jannah. Again, it was Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, my young friends. I've been asked to make an appeal for a center in Oslo in which the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be taught, the Quran will be taught. And the best reward that you will get is if you participate in centers like this, because once you've left this world, the sadaqah you will keep on receiving. When the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were not content in terms of their akhirah, why should you and I be content in terms of our akhirah? Do what you can while you can, because you only live once. You're here today, you're gone tomorrow. And the only thing that will benefit you in terms of your akhirah are the a'mal that you've done in the dunya while you were here. Please, please, please participate in this good deed. You will not regret it on the day of judgment. Allah give me tawfiq, Allah give you tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.